అమృతవాణి
ఓ ప్రేమవాణి
ఓ ప్రేమవాణి
అమృతవాణి.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. The grace of Lord and His blessings be always upon you. Dear brothers and sisters in Christ, we encounter God. God and we meet. Human beings and God meet. The meeting point between God and human beings was the Garden of Eden, when God created the world. And then due to their sin, Adam and Eve had to vacate this garden. And then later we see how God talked to people down the centuries, to Enoch, to Noah, to Abraham the patriarch, and then to his sons Isaac, Jacob. And then he talked to the Israelites through Moses. He rescued them, and his presence with them. He was present to them in the pillar of cloud, in the pillar of fire through that cloud, and then he was also present to them in the tabernacle. Later, his presence was seen in the temple, and slowly the temple of Jerusalem became the epitome of their lives, where every Israelite would love to come to the presence of God, because he was sure of the presence of God in Jerusalem temple. Sure, God's presence was there, 100%. They had that surety, and it was there. But what happened, even knowing that God's presence is 100% there, you see the guts that they had to turn it into a marketplace. Because slowly the importance that they were giving was shifted. The importance is now no longer given to the presence of God, but importance is given now to the presence of money in the pockets. It is given to the presence of monetary benefits. You can even sell God. That's how they became. And this is what Jesus strictly, outrightly condemned on the face. Today we see Jesus turning the tables of those tax collectors and those money changers and those people who were misusing the name of God. So dear brothers and sisters, today in the Eucharist to us, the Lord comes. We are sure that we are going to meet our Savior in the Eucharist, that He is going to come and He is going to get into us through that Eucharist. And still, many of us go after first reading, second reading, or even after Gospel. Many of us receive the Eucharist without the sacrament of confession. When have you confessed, Ma? I think I don't remember, Father, long ago. And there are so many things we receive the communion in sin. We misuse the name of God. We just come to church so that we can keep to that title of being a Catholic or Christian. We come to church so that just for the protocol and the portfolio of being belonging to this religion. So dear brothers and sisters, today Jesus is condemning us. He's condemning us on the face and telling that you shall not profane the temple of my God. For every time that we have done it, let us ask Lord sorry and pardon. Dear brothers and sisters, we are not called to exploit the holy place of God. We are not called to exploit His holy temple. We are not called to do so. We end up exploiting it because we either do not know the value of it or we do not value it. So let us examine and see what is the value of the temple of God in our lives. Why do I go to church? What do I do in church? What do I gain from that place? Do I really experience God in the Eucharist? When I say Amen and receive the communion, what does my Amen mean? After receiving communion and coming back to my place, am I really praying or just closing my eyes for protocol's sake, so that people don't think that, see, this person is not praying even after receiving communion. Reflect each one of us, please. Reflect and see in our own lives how we are treating the temple of God. That is our body, that is the church, that is the community of believers. We belong to the church, yet we do not know the names of our parishioners. We belong to the church, but still we just keep to the minimum of just putting an attendance and coming back. So all this really reflects of what we think the church is. If today Jesus comes to a church, stands outside, will he condemn us or will he appreciate us? Will he turn our tables up and condemn us? So let us look at the way we are, the church today, and ask Lord pardon and mercy. Let's say this little prayer. Eternal Father God, we offer you our church, we offer you our temple of today, our bodies and the body of church. Lord, help us to keep it holy and blameless. For you, our God, is holy. We make this prayer through Christ our Lord. Amen.